Wait, so can we start now? What? Ready? Okay, hi, I'm Edwin. I'm back up again. I want to be culture trip because I really love the Filipino culture. I just really enjoy it, and I want to share my love with the Filipino culture with everybody here. I went on the UFC retreat, and there's a freshman group where we talked about a lot of things we could do. Arthur was there, and a whole bunch of Jeremy, a whole bunch of other Vincent, he was there. And we talked about like things we can do. And I said, like, my ideas were like with Arthur, like a bilingual buy-in box for the orphans, a cooking night where we have like a cooking showdown with the Filipino recipes. What I really liked, what Arthur said once, was a dialogue circle. We can all practice our Tagalog together and have like a other Filipino dialects that we would just enjoy. I think I just really love it. And I want to hear like other people's ideas too about what else they want to learn about their culture. And yeah, God bless.
Hi everyone, my name is Elaine Ignau and I want to be your cultural chair next year. Being active and feeling a part of this close-knit family like UFC honestly makes me feel like I never left home. The organization has helped me stay connected with my Filipino culture and learn more about myself as an individual, especially when I was given the opportunity to be co-food chair for Barrio Committee. If elected, I will do my best to immerse the members of UFC and the Filipino culture through activities and events. I want to be able to spread cultural awareness to everyone as an inspiration and a reminder that being Filipino is something to be proud of and is a part of our identity which should not be forgotten. I also want to allow UFC to continue embodying that sense of family for members to find and develop their home away from home, like I did. Not only do I want to reciprocate that experience to the UFC members next year as cultural chair, thank you for your time, and please vote for me for next year's cultural chair.
So I identify as a Filipino American, but what does that mean exactly? What is a tabo? Why do our parents and grandparents point with their lips when they want to? But I can find those answers for you, and not only that, we would be learning together. And just this past weekend, I made lumpia.
Well,
I didn't really make it, I fried it.
That's scary, but you know, whatever. We can make it together. I also made bico or kalamay or sweet rice cake, depending on how you learned it growing up. And it turned out amazing, by the way. It's right here.
Stop tapping off the food!
So you're not.
Not only will I feed your hunger for knowledge, but I will also feed your stomachs.
Oh. Thank you.
That's too much.
Make sure. I will hold her that.
We'll get Sammy.
Stand under.
You guys go underneath Sammy.
Sammy.
She is
having a good life.
Okay.
With how many glasses of wine?
Hey guys, so Clarissa isn't here, so since I'm past cultural chair, I'll ask a question. According to the Constitution of the United Filipino Club, the cultural chair position is pretty broad, and there's not too many guidelines besides, you know, Filipino cultural one. So I have a two-part question. First part is, how do you intend to make your position your own? How do you make it unique or special to you? And my second question is, how do you plan to implement your ideas? Being that there's so many different activities and plans and things going on throughout the year, like Barrio, other cultural activities and whatnot, community service. So, pretty much that. How do you make your position your own, and how are you going to implement your ideas?
Well, I have a bunch of ideas, like doing the development dialogue circles, and then I also like the Balakbayan blocks. But then also I want to be able to have an activity each meeting to teach everyone about the Filipino culture. And I want to collaborate with other activities so we can spread cultural awareness within not only our group, but also with other clubs. And I also want to be able to collaborate specifically with FASA Sayudab and bring out like Sayang practices just so we can learn the dances not only during Barrio, but also throughout the year, and be able to have community service opportunities. I was just at the FCC last weekend, and they basically have Tagalog teaching classes for little kids, and so we could be able to help out with them. So.
For me, like I want to do all the events that I said during my speech, but one event that I forgot to add was I wanted to do Simbang Gabi for UFC during the winter time. So it's either like I would ask a church that so we can sponsor a night for UFC, or even bring UFC to our chapel here so we can do it during winter, for, especially for people who stay here during winter time and they just don't have anything to do. I feel like it gives them something to look forward to during the winter days.
Next question is, what makes you most proud to be Filipino?
Ooh. I just love being Filipino. I mean, we're all really good looking people. There's just so much things that we're just like looking at this community, that you can't feel nothing but pride just like being here right now.
I'm proud that we are able to accept everyone, no matter if they're Filipino or not. And one of the biggest things that makes me even more proud of being Filipino is the fact that I just learned a couple months ago from our meetings that we did have a revolution where it was not violent at all. And that just makes me more proud that we are peaceful.
And last question. Do you think that UFC should strive for a more diverse group of members, and why?
I definitely think we should do that. I mean, if we went to the OMA night where we had our showcase with a whole bunch of other groups, we actually gained some members. I saw Victor come in here earlier.
Okay.
Hey, Victor, he joined us. And I just like had so much fun just having him. Like he came to so many like of our events, and I just feel like he's not even Filipino. He just supported us. I feel like it's something that we should just show with everybody.
I also agree with Edwin. I feel like we should be open to other people because it doesn't matter if you're Filipino. It's the fact that we have a sense of community and family, and I feel like we should be able to open up with other people so that they can learn about our culture and we can learn about theirs.